Well, if you're gonna cap a monitor board, or cap a monitor, however you want to say it, you're gonna need to order a cap kit. And I get mine from Bob Roberts, and they come with a sheet just like this. And they'll tell you, they have a column on the left-hand side which tells you the values of the caps, and then the column to the right of that tells you the position where those caps go. For example, the first one on the list has a value of 1 UF, so it's 50 volts. And those caps go at positions C166, C302, C453, and C454, and so on. You just follow the list down, and it tells you which cap goes where. The first thing I do, and I don't normally do it like this, I did this for the sake of the video, so it's a little bit easier to see. But I go ahead and organize my caps in groups the same way Bob has them. Like I said, there's four caps that have a value of 1 UF, 50 volts. And that would be these four. And so on, going down the list, there's three caps that have a value of 1 UF, 160 volts, and then so on. The next two are the next, down the list, and so on. This grouping, one, two, three, and all the way down the list until you've got them all 100% cap. Just helps me organize them. And I also keep a pen handy in case I want to check off the caps as I go that they're actually completed. And I also go in order, or I would suggest going in order. I've done it other ways, but if you're new to this, I think that's definitely the best way. Just follow the list down the line. And that way you're sure, check them off as you go, that you're done, everything's complete. Just a note, I ran into this the very first cap kit I did, and I've ran into it every cap kit since. Bob has some very important notes at the bottom of the sheet, and actually, you need to go ahead and read them. They tell you about the fact that your capacitors have polarity. They have a positive and negative side to them. I'm gonna try to show you on this big cap. Hopefully you can see this the black line there. Well, within the black line is basically a negative sign. So this lead down here, the short lead, is your negative lead. And this long lead would be your positive. And all these caps are just like this. And every cap that I've dealt with so far is the same way. They tell you they have a black stripe that denotes the negative lead, but look at them. It could show a black stripe that had a positive marking, and then that would be your positive lead on that side. Also, you'll run into the fact that the value, the UF value, should always be dead on. If it says this cap uses 1 UF at that location, then it has to be a 1 UF cap. Now, the voltage can actually be higher. Even though it says that this cap at position C166 is supposed to be a 1 UF 50 volt, if it was a 1 UF 100 volt, that would be fine. And some of the caps you get from Bob Roberts, in my experience, have been just like that, and it's not a problem, and he tells you that right here on his sheet at the bottom. Okay, well, let's go ahead and get started. I'm gonna take my soldering iron here, dip it in my rosin flux a little bit, just get it going, clean off the tip on my damp sponge. And I'm gonna go to my list, as I said, and find that first cap on the list, which would be that cap at the 1 UF 50 volt value, which, like I said, I have a cluster of them over here. And essentially, that one, the first one I'm looking for, is C166. So I look at my board, and I can see right here is C166. Now, believe I mentioned this earlier, but if I didn't, this board is also marked on the bottom. So I can clearly see right here, I'm sorry, right here is C166, and I can see the marking for the positive and the negative polarity. So I'm going to put that right there. It's not going to hurt anything the way it's sitting. And get my wick. And I'm going to place my wick right, I just lost it. There we go, right on 166. And I'm going to take my soldering iron and touch it to it. And bam, right there. I don't know if you can see it, but the solder came right off. And I'm going to go to the other lead. I'm gonna do the same thing. And there you go, also, right off. I'm gonna reach around. And grab my cap. Now it's probably got a little solder left on there, so what I'm gonna do is without the wick, just heat it up just enough to get the cap loose. Alright, so now I've got those feet off. I could have went back in with the wick and got a little bit more solder off and it would have been fine. But I was okay with just doing it that way. It didn't hurt anything. Scraping off a little of the rosin, the flux, essentially, that melts to the board, to the leads, or whatever. It really doesn't hurt anything, but just kind of looks ugly. So we'll go ahead and clean that off a little bit, scrape it a little bit with my nail. But I'm going to go ahead and grab this cap, just for the sake of it. Take a close look. I would suggest that you do this. You won't be able to see this here, but yep, it's a 1 UF 50 volt value. So I'm going to set that one aside. I'm going to take this one, once again, the black stripe, negative lead. And like I said, it shows on this board, it can be really hard to see, but it shows the positive and negative marking. And I'm going to slip that through right there, just like I want it. Bend my leads out. Put the cap in nice and tight up against there. I don't want any extra length, really. I don't have any use for it. I don't plan on taking it out. So I'm not going to leave any extra. Grab my solder and my soldering iron. And just put the very smallest bit. I don't want a big amount. In fact, if I put too much, I would probably grab my wick and either suck that completely off or suck a bit of it off. Now I go ahead and take my little flush cutters here. I didn't mention these before, but I realized I was going to need them, a little something to get them closer. Cut off the ends of my leads, basically throw them away. And in essence, that's what you're going to do the whole way through. There's really not a big difference in the next steps. It's just repeat that over and over again. Let's see if we can get a closer look at this one. Check the value. Check for positive and negative polarity. Stick it through with your leads bent. A little bit of solder and a soldering iron. That's it. You can cut your leads. You just repeat the process, go down the checklist, mark them off as you go. It's not a big deal, it's not very hard. Like I said, you just make sure that you do not have splatter from your solder. Make sure you don't make any connections that weren't meant to be there. And that's about it.